Wasabi, Walnut, what's hurting my tummy? Wednesday, I'm back. My love has brothers, fathers, sisters, mothers, daughters, cousins, sons, and... Did I say daughters? I did. Yes. So I'm feeling a lot better. A patient who was kind of bringing me down two nights ago was not freaking out when I came back, which is awesome. Because he was leaving, and he was close to having to be restrained. Poor guy barricaded himself in the bathroom. Had to cut his favorite blanket. Didn't make him happy today, but we're in good spirits. He didn't see any demons and no buffaloes. He did not go to hell. He was way more aware of the feelings he was having and how they were directional in the direction of his brain tumor, which, fuck, I swear... I knew he was a nice guy while he was freaking out, because brain tumors only come after the nicest people. I've seen it so many times. Brain tumors, brain abscesses, they hit the nicest people. I don't know why they deserve it, but they do. That's too nice, brain tumor. So be an asshole, don't get brain tumor. That's the lesson of today's low-tech health, let ourselves translate expert knowledge with Brad Burr. There was one guy who had a brain abscess who was going to be on something really strong, amphotericin B, for a whole, well, it was either a year or 2 years, and he was having to go to a skilled nursing facility. He got a PICC line and everything, one of those invasive catheters, goes all the way to his heart. But the first week when he got this antifungal, the ampho B, he had histoplasmosis in his brain abscess, pretty rough. As soon as he got it, His legs turned into Lizard Man, like from Spider-Man. His legs looked scaly. They were swollen, so they gave him Lasix to try to pull out the fluid, but it didn't get rid of the scaliness. And this poor guy was Egyptian, if I'm remembering correctly, so English was not his first language. And he was refusing the ampho-B for the rest of the time he was there. And he just kept asking, "What's that doctor going to do about my legs?" And I was like, we need to get you this antifungal, because this brain abscess will get worse. You'll have changes. It won't be comfortable. You'll be scared. Things will happen. You could possibly die from this. Because what about my legs? And I didn't have an answer. It sucked. He was so nice. I get it. If my legs turned into Lizard Man, I'd have some questions. And I'd want some answers, which we didn't have answers for him. We don't know why that happened. Some people, this happens. It's like the end of Beetlejuice. Like, is this what happens when you die? This is what happens when she dies. This isn't what happens when he dies. This is what happens when they die. And it's different for everyone. Your reaction, an allergic reaction, could be different for everyone. Which brings us to today's topic, practicing good health tonight. Practicing questioning. Why do we drink cow's milk? We're not baby cows. We're the one species that drinks milk from an udder after weaned. And it's not even our species. It's udder. It's a different udder. It's utterly ridiculous. And it can cause bloating. We're really not evolved enough for it to take in this nasty gunk, and the way it's processed, homogenized, pasteurized, it bursts those little free radicals out of those tiny little globules in cow's milk, and we drink it. A lot of people drink it every day. There are some diets called the GOMAD diet to help bros gain weight, and I'll tell you, Wasabi Wana, what's hurting your tummy Wednesday, that will hurt your tummy. They even say on the page, expect some bloating, expect some pain, but you're guaranteed to gain 20 pounds in 25 days. Something crazy like that. Because the GOMAD stands for gallon of milk a day. Wow, isn't that insane? A little bit. I just wouldn't prescribe to it. I wouldn't recommend it. Because as I am trying to explain, we are not evolved enough for this. But anyways... back to the guy who was hallucinating. No more! When he was going to bed, he was still freaking out. He said the walls were rolling on him. And I told him about the 5-4-3-2-1 practice that I mentioned earlier in the week, or maybe it was last week, where you touch five things, look at four things. listen for three different things, smell two things, and then taste one thing. And you name them out loud, like you're touching the laptop, I'm touching the microphone, I'm touching my glasses, my nose, my chin. And then you move on to sight, like I see myself, I see the light. And you do this progressively, and what it does is it helps pull your anxiety into check. And he was using it to see, I can't, am I touching these demons? No, I'm not touching them. They're not real. And he was able to talk himself down. That and stopping the fucking steroids that, you know, necessary, that will help his brain swelling go down. But you can have steroid-induced psychosis. Steroids tend to keep people up and make them feel a little wired. And on top of the steroids' effect of making you a little wired and kooky, staying up, he said he was up the better part of 120 hours. Which is enough to make even the strongest mind break. But he didn't break all the way. And like I said, I knew he was going to be nice. I knew he was going to be all right. We were doing the Lord's Prayer at the bedside. I happened to be off the floor when he had his full freak out, the initial one. And I did him a disservice. I wish I'd been there, because I know I would have been able to calm him down sooner and not escalate it. There was a dude on the floor, and he escalated it, tried to shove some Ativan in this man. Benzos are not what this dude needed. He needed an anti-psych, which we started olanzapine or Zyprexa, which works very well for this kind of freak-out agitation. And it doesn't have the QTC prolongation effects that Haldol does, which basically can fuck up your heart, maybe cause VTAC, which is where your heart just stops. It doesn't beat correctly. But anyways, on that note, Wasabi Walnut, What's Hurting My Tummy Wednesday? Not a tang, because I feel good. Thank you. I hope you all have a good 2 days, and I'll see you on friggin' my foul mouth Friday. I love you. Thank you for listening. It's Brad Burns, signing off.